Hello. Again, welcome in the new video. In previous video, we have discussed about the nature of the roots of the auxiliary equation. If the roots were real and distinct, then the complementary function will be c1 e to the power m1x plus c2 e to the power m2x. By considering this methodology, we find out the complementary function of this particular equation. We again move forward in the next problem, where the roots of the auxiliary equation were equal. Then we find out the complementary function by using this particular methodology, and we have also discussed an example based on the both of the concepts. Now we'll move forward and we will discuss about the concept, that is complementary function roots of the complementary function when roots of auxiliary equation are complex, that is alpha plus minus I beta, or irrational pair. Irrational pair indicates alpha plus minus beta, where both alpha and beta are irrational. Here the irrational stands for alpha will be either root p1, or beta will be root p2, where p1 and p2 both are prime numbers, right? So now we will go through this concept. Okay, so the concept will be we are having an auxiliary equation for second order differential equation that is M2 plus Pm plus Q, that is equal to 0. If roots are alpha plus minus I beta, where alpha and beta can be any real number, and alpha plus minus I beta is a pair of complex numbers. One thing that you all have to remember, that the complex root will always be in a pair form, means it will not be alone alpha plus I beta or alpha minus I beta. Okay, it will not be possible that roots of complex are alone. It will be always in the form of alpha and alpha plus minus I beta, right? Then in case our complementary function will be e to the power alpha x c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x, right? So in this case the complementary function will be given by this particular formula. Now, the second point. Before discussing the second point, we will go through an example. Let's see that. Okay. So, the example is d2 minus 2d plus 5 y that is equal to 0. This is the standard operator form of a differential equation. Our target is to find out the solution of this differential equation. And we all know, and I have also discussed in my previous videos, that the solution of a homogeneous, this is a homogeneous differential equation. Right? The solution of the homogeneous differential equation is called the complementary function. So, in order to find out, let's deal with the solution of it. In order to find out the solution of this particular differential equation, we have to go through the auxiliary equation. Let's go through that. Auxiliary equation will be replace d by m2 minus 2m plus 5 that is equals to 0. Okay, if we are going through to find out the factors of this equation, that will be really very difficult, because there is no divisor of y or there is no factor of y by which adding we can get the number 2. So here we have to apply the biquadratic formula, that is Sri Dharacharya rule, using Sri Dharacharya rule, or for CBSC board students, quadratic formula. Quadratic formula that says the roots of this equation will be given by m equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. That means minus b means here we are having the value of b is minus 2. So minus minus will be cancelled out and it will be plus 2 plus minus under root b square, that means 4 minus 4. The value of a is 1 and the value of c is 5. C is the constant term, divided by 2a, that means 2 multiply by 1. So here we are having 2 plus minus under root 4 minus 5 4s are 20 divided by 2, and that is 2 plus minus root minus 16 divided by 2. And we all aware that the value of minus 1 is iota square. So here this minus 1 will be replaced by the iota square 2 plus minus iota square 16 divided by 2. Here we will have 2 divided by 2 plus minus 4 iota divided by 2. 2 is a 4, 1 plus minus 2y. So we are having a pair, okay, and initially I told you that the roots, complex roots, will always occur in a pair form. So this is a pair form. Then by using our formula, we'll go through that formula, e to the power alpha x, alpha is here 1 and the beta is 2. Okay, so now we can write its solution here. The complementary function will be, that is also the solution of the homogeneous differential equation, that is e to the power alpha x, that is e to the power 1 into x, x c1 cos beta, that is 2x, plus c2 sin 2x. So this is the final answer, and this is how we can find out the complex root of a differential of an auxiliary equation. Now we will move forward for the another type. The another type and the last type to find out the complementary function is that if the roots of the auxiliary equation are irrational, that is, the value of m is alpha 1 plus minus beta 1. Here alpha 1 and alpha 2 are irrational numbers. Then in case complementary function will be e to the power alpha 1 x c 1. Here mark that cos hyperbolic beta x plus c 2 sin hyperbolic beta x will be the solution of that particular equation, right? So you have to mark that concept. Now based on this concept we will discuss the example. Let's see the example. Okay, so we are having this example d2 minus 4d plus 1 y equal to 0. Here again this is the form that is already in the operator condition. So in order to apply our method, we have to do first, we have to find the auxiliary equation. The auxiliary equation will be m2 minus 4m plus 1, that is equal to 0. That means now we have to find the factors of this equation or find the root of this equation. So in order to find the root, there is no divisor of 1 or there is no factor of 1 by adding, we can get the 4. Therefore we can use again the Sridharacharya rule. That rule says m will be equal to minus b minus minus 4. Here the value of b is minus 4. So minus minus plus plus minus under root b square, that is 4 4s are 16 minus 4 a. The value of a is 1 and the value of c is also 1 divided upon 2a. So by solving this we will have 4 by 2 plus minus 16 minus 4, that will be 12, that is root 12 divided by 2. Then we will have m equals to 2, 2 to the 4 plus minus, and the 12 it can be written as 2 root 3 divided by 2, and then this is, so this will be 2 plus minus under root 3. The root 12 you can mark here, root 12 can be written as root 4 into 3. 4 can be outside of this under root, it will be 2 root 3. So you can mark that, right? Although there is no need to make you understand about this, but there are few students who are really very confused about these things, so pardon for them. Okay, so now moving forward, here we are having the values, one is rational and the other is irrational. And the very famous theorem of real analysis says that the sum of a rational and irrational number is also called a irrational number. So this is a pair of two irrational numbers, and here we will have the complementary function, that is also the solution of the homogeneous differential equation, that will be e to the power alpha. The value of alpha is alpha 1, that is 2. So that is e to the power 2x. Next, c1 cos hyperbolic beta, the value of beta is root 3x plus c2 sin hyperbolic root 3x. Okay, so this is your final answer. So dear students, in this video we have covered two topics, and here we can end the complementary function concept. In the next video we will go through some higher order homogeneous differential equation and their solution using auxiliary equation. So stay tuned in this channel. So if you want to learn about this topic, you have to subscribe the channel so that you can get the notifications on time. Till then, be happy, keep your parents happy, and work hard, because you have to make yourself proud. Thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.